Motown on Showtime. The Temptations and Four Tops. Hosted by Stevie Wonder.
Drink, you can't have your favorite food without having a favorite Four Tops song. Well, this particular song happens to be mine, and I'm going to sing it right now and do the Four Tops. There. Hey, ooh, ah, ee, ooh, sugar pie, honey bun. You know that I love you. I can't help myself. I love you again. Background. Can't help myself. Ooh. Sugar, sugar, sugar. Anything you ask me to do, ask me to. I can't help myself. I love you and nobody else. And I'm crazy about the Four Tops. Ooh.
Hi, Stevie Wonder here. The Temps and Tops. They've been major figures of the pop music era for over 25 years. Not too many groups have earned the devotion of generations of fans, and not many performers have had the kind of influence on our culture that these guys have had. That's what I love about the Temps and Tops. You see, they always live up to the highest standards of great entertainment, because they actually define those standards. This building behind me is a studio where most Motown records are made today. Hitsville in Los Angeles. But back in the 60s, the place where it all happened was Detroit. When Berry Gordy Jr. founded Motown in the late 50s, he had a vision that good music by black entertainers was good for all people. But even Berry was surprised by the profound impact Motown had on the music industry. By the mid-60s, everyone was talking about the Motown sound. It transcended all kinds of musical and racial barriers. And you know what? We had a good time, too.
Mm-hmm.
Louisville, USA, the original Motown recording studio. It's hard to believe that this is where so much magic and history were made. I remember when this place was like a second home to artists like myself and I'm sure the Four Tops.
Hey, Lawrence, you know, this place seemed to be a lot larger then, though, man.
Well, Levi, that's because you were a little smaller.
You might be right.
One thing I remember about Hitsville is that the air was always charged with creativity and with music. All of us walked into Hitsville with nothing but talent and dreams. And I guess some would say we came out superstars. Smokey Robinson and the Miracles, Marvin Gaye, Diana Ross and the Supremes, Michael Jackson and the Jackson 5, the Temptations, the Four Tops, wow, and even little Stevie Wonder. The Four Tops, Levi, Duke, Opie, and Lawrence, still live in Detroit. They've been singing together for 32 years and have made 33 albums. We're talking a silver anniversary plus seven. These guys are far more than just an actor. They're a family. When they stood in front of those mics and sang, they gave new meaning to the word magic.
Well, there we are, right there, right in the middle of all those stars. When we were growing up in Detroit on the north side, I don't think we ever dreamed we would be making the albums quite like that. The North End was really the blue-collar part of town. It was hardworking, and all the kids were very competitive. They were either into sports, or there was a group singing on every corner, or you were both. You played ball and you sung, according to how popular you wanted to become. So, Obie, Levi, and Lawrence, we all played ball. And even, we just put our voices together, and there it was. We knew it the moment we hit our first note.
When you feel that news and make it all alone, remember no one is big enough to go alone.
Four rooms are part of the Motown Museum here at Hitsville, USA. When I look around, it really reminds me of those early days. But the Tops go back even before Motown. I mean, we did things way back before we recorded with Billy Eckstine and Vegas, Larry Steele and Lake City. Great, great, great things, and we're still doing them.
You know, in the 60s, the Beatles and a lot of other British groups invaded America. So Barry Gordy decided to return the favor and send us over to England. Oh, the tour was awesome. You know, it was something that I've been about all my life. And Brian Epstein promoted us the same way that they promoted the Beatles in America. And the British people received us very well. The feeling was all there. And all this would not have been possible had we not been the same little boy standing out on the porch of this Hitsville, USA building, and Barry Gordy had given us the opportunity to record our feelings.
Look at all that music. A lot of those hits and most of ours were written by one of Motown's top creative teams, Holland, Dozier, and Holland.
It really feels strange, you know. You can just picture seeing Holland and Dozier and Holland standing in the control room, you know, with all the cats, you know.
Yeah. Like when Barry would come down, or Esther, and all, everybody would fill it out.
Yeah.
And be looking in the window.
Yeah.
That's when you knew he had a hit.
Yeah.
I remember one night they came down to a club that we were working in and said they had something really, really hot for us. It turned out to be Baby, I Need Your Lovin'. And I'll tell you, it was hot.
So one of those groups who can take any song and make it sound like it's always belonged to them.
The time to hesitate is through. We got no time to wallow in the mire. And baby, we could only lose. And our love could become a funeral pyre. In a song.
Aretha Franklin and the Four Tops are all Detroit natives. In fact, Aretha knew them in the beginning when they called themselves the Ames.
Four Ames, too, remember?
Oh, yeah.
Remember those guys?
Come out the little sharp little guys.
It's a blue world without you. It's a blue.
Say that.
For me.
Ooh, we like
it. You still got it. You still got it, man.
Yeah.
One of the great things about the friendship those of us in Detroit have with one another is that it doesn't matter where our careers take us or what success God blesses us with, we somehow always manage to pick up where we left off. The Tops even sang at Aretha's wedding. And I must say, I was personally impressed by their choice of material.
Remember the wedding.
Of course.
Remember the
course.
Wedding. When you all did, isn't she lovely?
Oh,
and you
can
were.
We do that?
Sure.
Yeah, okay.
Sure.
Isn't she lovely? Isn't she wonderful? Isn't she precious?
I really am. I really am.
Aretha is lovely, made from stuff. I never thought that love could be.
Oh, yeah.
Isn't she lovely, made from love?
Yeah. Talking about you.
Did she do something from the 20s or something?
Yes, yes,
yes. Yeah.
That is. Yes.
Come on, sing it then.
Yeah.
Rock-a-bye.
Pretty good.
Your baby with a Dixon melody.
Come on.
When you crew, crew the tune.
Bye-bye.
From the heart of Poughkeepsie.
What was that great song that Levi and Ricky used to sing a long time ago?
Yeah,
do you remember that song? We used to do it every time we ran into each other.
I think it was, but I don't remember.
That was it. That was it. He was on your album.
On the
Four Tops on Broadway.
Mm-hmm. That's been many years.
Oh, I love that song. I don't remember it either, but hey.
Do you remember, yeah. You remember any of the chords at all, dude?
Yeah. Yeah. You want to sing it anyway?
Why not?
Let's see. What's a good key for you?
Whiskey.
G sharp?
Yeah, that's all right.
Okay. I want to be with you.
I want to be with you, too.
Can I be there, too?
I want to be with you.
We come as a package.
After all night. Of wanting you.
Say that. Say that.
Lying there. You.
Yeah.
Hating you.
Hey.
Oh. Tonight I'm touching you.
Yeah.
Why don't you say
holding you. Right?
Yeah.
Where are you gonna see? Yeah. We'll make out.
Don't do that.
Here's Levi and me.
All right.
I'm gonna love you every day.
Every day?
24 hours a day, baby, darling. Now sing for me, Reed.
After all those nights, I can't look at Jim sing. Lying there, loving you, wanting you. He's married. Hating you.
Loving you. World, you're gonna see.
What they gonna see?
We'll make out somehow.
We'll make out somehow.
Here's my guess.
You know, it's amazing that when you hear an oldie on the radio, you immediately remember where you were and what you were doing when the song first came out.
I know you won't leave me. I refuse to let you go.
In the movie The Big Chill, a group of friends have a reunion and reminisce about being young in the 60s. I don't think anyone has gotten over their love affair with the Temps. I know I haven't.
We were appearing at the Apollo Theater when our friend Smokey Robinson first brought us My Girl. We knew it was a smash. But we didn't know it was going to be number one for 6 weeks.
You got a smile for Friday.
He is also the fella that gave us our very first hit, The Way You Do the Things You Do.
I'm holding you so tight. You know you could have been a handle. The way you put me off the field. You know you could have been a broom. The way you smell so sweet. You know you could have been some perfume. Well, you could have been anything that you wanted to. And I can tell the way you do the things you do.
There have been 14 temptations in 10 different combinations, and God knows how many suits. Second largest movie theater in the world, and one of the most beautiful. Here at the Fox is where the Motown stars got ready for the world, and Charlie Atkins is a man who got them ready for the Fox. Honey Coles and Charlie Atkins were one of the country's leading tap dancing duos. Berry Gordy hired Charlie, or Pops as we still call him, to create the classic Temptations choreography.
I thought you'd like that.
Hey, Charlie, look, we just got this new record out. Uh-huh. We're very glad you flew in. We need your help. We need some choreography real fast.
Let's set up our old mic stands.
All right.
The old practice. And see if we can get into a few steps right here. Come on, punch in the tape now.
Okay.
Now give me a count. We'll start.
To the right.
One, two, you know what to do.
Yeah.
Hey. Chuck. Hey. Hey. Now you got it. I know you know this step. show you the new Temptation Walk.
Okay.
Yeah. I'll demonstrate, then you see if you can pick it up.
All right.
Start when you feel like you got it. Okay? You know what to do. Now here. Hey. Now take it around in a circle. Start on the right side. Go around in a circle. Got it? Go around.
Don't lose it.
By the way, Charlie, I'm still waiting for those tap dance steps you promised me. Over the years, the way the Timps move on stage has been a great inspiration to many entertainers. Lots of groups have tried to emulate their fancy footwork. Now, it's even influencing a whole new generation of young artists. Like New Edition.
Loving the Temptations, we grew up trying to copy their steps and everything. So it was great meeting them.
Keep on doing what you're doing, because you're doing it well. Yeah.
Eddie Kendricks is a temp that inspired just about every tenor in the 60s.
a member of a group that's a part of American history is truly a wonderful feeling. I myself had a group in school, and we, like other groups, chose a member in the Temptations to pattern ourselves after. And I chose you, Eddie Kendrick, because you're my idol.
It's hard to describe how I felt as a young kid growing up in Alabama, so far away from the music business, and then ending up as a lead singer in one of the hottest groups in the country. You know how the Temps got started? In 1960, Paul Williams and I were in a group called the Primes. We got together with Otis Williams, Melvin Franklin, and Elvis Bryant of the Distance, and became the Elgins. When we signed with Motown, our name was changed to the Temptations. A couple of years later, Elbridge was replaced by David Ruffin, and we really started to roll.
The Temptations used to call themselves the Primes. A group of girls joined them, and then the group called themselves the Primettes. And out of this combination, the boys became the Temptations, and the girls became the Supremes. Now here they are together on TV for the first time, the Temptations and the Supremes singing a medley of each other's hits.
When David Ruffin left the group in 1968, he was replaced with another preacher's son from another Motown group called the Contours, Dennis Edwards.
Can turn a gray sky blue.
Our collaboration with producer-writer Norman Whitfield was one of the greatest successes in pop music. Together we won Motown's first Grammy and turned out 21 top 10 records. 11 of them went to number one, like this song.
Sunshine, blue skies, please go. My love has found another and gone away. With the wind, my future, my life is filled with gloom.
Becoming a Temptation was like coming home for me. For in the past, I used to sing with Melvin and Otis. And I used to be a stand-in sometimes when someone would miss rehearsal or not show up or need another background part. I would always be Johnny on the spot. So I knew one day, hopefully, I would get back with the group that I dearly love. And now, I'm a stand-in all the time.
I was watching Motown 25, you know, the part where the Four Tops and the Temps were out there singing and they were cutting in on each other's songs, and Levi grabbed the mic and said, "It's all over your face, someone's taking your place," pointing at Dennis, and a cold chill came over my body, you know, and I said, "Wow, could it be me?"
I think it's safe to say that no one has a voice like Melvin Franklin's. Melvin's had that great bass sound since he was 14 years old. Back when he was a member of the Pretemps group, The Distance.
Old Man River. Old Man River. Old Man River. You don't say nothing. He must know something. Oh, old man river. He just keeps rolling along.
Paul Williams was the backbone of the Temptations, the man who held us together. And he was a great singer who really felt a song and made you believe it. I remember there was one song he sang that used to stop the show every night. And when I hear it today, I can't help but think of Paul. I really do miss him.
In 1982, Rick James, who happens to be Melvin Franklin's nephew, wrote Standing on the Top for the Temptations reunion album. For this record, and even the tour, Eddie Kendricks and David Ruffin rejoined the group. It was great having them all together again.
Present I could possibly have, I've got today, and that's having the Temptations back together again and singing this record with me.
You know, back in the mid-60s, I got to be very close with an awful lot of Motown's top artists. We had a thing called the Dick Clark Caravan of Stars. Let me tell you what that was. We would rent a bus, 15 acts in that bus, and we would travel all around the country doing one-nighters. And I tell you, nothing gets people closer than traveling on a bus from city to city. You haven't lived until you've seen the Supremes get up at 5 o'clock in the morning after all night on the bus. I mean, so you really know people. And during that same period, in addition to American Bandstand, we were doing a show called Where the Action Is. Now, where the action was in those days was the home of the Motown sound, Detroit, Michigan. And as a matter of fact, we took the show there, and we featured two groups who were destined to remain top stars for the next quarter of a century. The Temptations and the Four Tops. They performed all over town on that trip. But one of the most meaningful locations was a very famous club on the Detroit River. It was the place that Motown artists loved to play for their families, and their friends, and their fans, and it was called the Rooster Tail.
Every day, not today. Well, I'm an evil woman, should be treated with the utmost respect. Baby, see, don't be afraid, don't turn and walk away. I wanna get to know you, baby. Don't be ashamed, don't say enough to blame. Just come and look me over. Anybody, I'm too much more.
1983. I'll never forget 1983 because that was a year we celebrated a quarter century of music and friendship. Motown 25. Yesterday, today, forever. One of the most popular moments of the show was when the Four Tops and the Temptations sang each other's hits. That was a battle of the bands, all right. And guess what? They both beat. Temptations and the Four Tops. Between them, they represent over a half century of show business history. Their personality and their music has given us so much pleasure. They've become our good friends and our mine. And the wonderful thing about it is that they're still going higher and higher. The Temps and the Tops. They're here to stay. And I'm here to say that I love them.
Forever. I'm